Yo, guys, what is up? Welcome back to another episode of Marijuana SA Weekly. Today we are here to explain to you every piece of a hydroponic grow system. We've taken the time to just break down basically every little bit that you would put into a system to grow hydroponically. This relates to sort of every aspect of, you know, whatever you're growing, you can utilize these things. And the general system, you can see on the sides, it's going to fit into a 1.2 by 1.2 tent. We've got a nano light, and then sort of that's the base size of the unit. So like roughly how many plants would we be looking at, Dean?
So with this specific setup that we're talking about today, we're going to be looking at around 16 plants, and that's going to, those will fit very nicely on 5.8 liter pots onto the well, we said here 1 by 1, but it's technically a 0.98 by 0.98. so basically this, everything we're going to talk about here is to support those 16 plants on the drip tray. And this, compared to sort of a lot of organic content that we've done, we're now moving more into a sort of high density stacking kind of environment. Comes with its pluses and its minuses. But yeah, it's a really exciting system to be bringing forth today, because it's, you know, it's a different style of growing completely to the way that we have been putting a lot, to compared to a lot of the content that we've put up until this point.
And we want to quickly include what's not included, or mention what's not included, is obviously you guys probably need electricity to run this. And as of the time of this recording, a lot of SA is in electricity shortages. That's why we've included the inverter and battery setup. Unfortunately, load shedding is a problem for us. But if you're international and you've got a steady electricity supply, that's an easy one. There's no genetic included in this, you know, so whatever you're growing, you would want to factor that in to make sure that you have that, whether you're growing from a clone or whether you're growing from a seed, whatever your choice is, that you would also have to get. And a couple other small little things, your IPM isn't included, so anything with related to pest management, fly traps, insecticides, pesticides, things like that, those aren't included because that's quite an in-depth one. We would highly recommend that.
And substrates, you know, pots, those sorts of things. We more wanted to go into the system over the, you know, the running of the system. Like, how can we build up the system? What are we going to require? And yeah, we can, you know, it's going far more in depth, and there's already loads of components on here. So, you know, maybe an episode 2.
Yeah, brilliant. So let's start off, you know, so we've got obviously, between these, all the adapters and the piping, if you want to walk us through that as sort of the starting point.
Okay, so just quickly to start, there's also one other item that's not on here, and that's your reservoir. Your reservoir is going to sit under your table, and basically we're building up this table from the ground up. There's two different kinds of piping that you can see in front of us here. We've got our 20 millimeter piping, and then we've got our 3 millimeter piping. The 20 millimeter piping is basically going to formulate like the main side of the system. The pump will attach onto the bottom of the piping, and then that will pump upwards onto your table, and then we'll use the 90 degree bend to make it run along the center of the table. So now all of a sudden you've got your reservoir, you've got your pipe running upwards. In that line where the pipe is running upwards, I like to put in sort of that cutoff valve. It's not 100% necessary, but you can do it. And then at the end of the piping at the other end, you're putting your end adapter. So now basically you've got a sealed pipe running from your pump up and along your table, which kind of gives you your kind of framework as to now how you're going to sort of start to build it up. And then after that, we can have a look at our manifold adapter. The manifold adapter, you make a small little hole into the pipe, equal distances apart. And then on the manifold adapter, you would attach a four-way manifold. So obviously 4 times 4 equals 16. And all of a sudden we have the ability to attach 16 pots onto this one super simple, super simple system. So it's...
And then on this manifold, these are 3 millimeter outlets, right?
Correct.
Okay, and that's for this the 3 millimeter piping, which would come in there.
after that period, obviously, you would measure out your 3 millimeter piping in equal lengths. And then at the end of each pipe, you would get a dripper. A lot of you might know them as netafim spikes or irrigation spikes. But those are basically the guys that fit into each pot and now allow the water to flow freely into the pot on the system. So all in all, you've basically now just built yourself a irrigation system. And I just want to put in here that, you know, this is obviously the way that I've described it now is specifically for this drip tray and table, but you could, you know, the creativity at this point allows you to really start to think, maybe I could do crazy things using irrigation. And that's also, you know, a topic we wanted to open up with this podcast.
100%. Now, obviously, you have all this irrigation going. How are you going to control all of this this irrigation?
So specifically for this one, I wanted to touch again on the automation aspect of the Trollmaster. So the brains beside your brain in this operation is going to be your Trollmaster. It's a piece of automation tech. And then I've allowed us to have two different, I've put two different adapters here for the Trollmaster. The Trollmaster will give you a temperature, humidity, and VPD reading already. It comes standard with a sensor. It's also got a light sensor, meaning if there's light going into your grow during the dark period, it will give you an alert. So those are all aspects that you now have reporting on. And then there's two other things we need to control. There's our Nanolux light, which we've selected here. The reason we suggest the Nanolux as ZX or EX specifically is because it has the 0 to 10 volt adapter or input on it. So you can plug your Trollmaster via an adapter called the LMA14 lighting adapter. You can plug that into your Nanolux, and now you have the ability to do a sunrise, sunset, and to do a timer, and to do a dimming functionality as well. So that's all the aspects of the light. And then we have for the watering, we've got our DSP2 program station, and that is a station that you can basically put on for, well, it has two different settings. It's got like you could run it for a set amount of time, you know, 1 minute, 1 hour, 24 hours. Or alternatively, the way that I like to use it, it's got something called bi-recycle. And that basically means it can run, you can set the amount of time it can run, the amount of time it will be off for between each time it runs, and then the frequency of that. So for example, if I want to run it for 3 minutes, two times a day, it would turn on for 3 minutes, it would turn off for the amount of time that I've mentioned, and then it would turn on for another 3 minutes, and then the program function would be done for that day. And obviously you plug your pump into the program station, and now all of a sudden, via your Trollmaster, both your lighting and your watering is being controlled by the piece of technology.
It's basically, this would turn on the pump.
Exactly.
100%. Okay, cool.
In the settings that you want. Obviously, all of this for the sake of this piece of content, we've everything is going to go into a 1.2 by 1.2 meter grow tent. And now you kind of start to assemble everything, you know, light in the grow tent. Then you're obviously going to need to put your table inside the grow tent. The table is basically a frame pictured here, is slightly larger, but it would be a very similar square kind of table. And then you have your drip tray, which would go on top of the table. If you have a look quite closely at the drip tray, you can see there's grooves in it, so the pots can sit and there's still space for the water to run. And then on the far side from us, you see an indented piece. You make drill a 20 millimeter hole through that. You run your piping from your pump. Then you use a heat gun and you kind of just make so that the hole kind of goes to the bottom woods a little bit, you know, a slight curve so that it doesn't drip at an uneven angle. And then you place your reservoir with your pump below the table, and your 20 millimeter pipe actually runs directly through the table, allowing a little bit of a gap around. So the water comes through, and then when it runs back again, it's also running back into that same hole. And for the sake of us that like everything neat, you know, everything now looks nice and neat and clean. And you basically, essentially now you have a functioning lighting and watering system within the grow space.
100%. And then obviously, what else is getting connected into some of your timing? Or would you have your inline and your oscillating? Those are going to be running basically around the clock, along with some ducting.
100%. So you're dealing with, I would suggest putting a lid on top of your reservoir as well, because light going into your reservoir is going to affect it. But essentially, all more of your production. Ventilation systems are going to be running round the clock. You could, at a later stage, attach your inline fan and your dehumidifier onto additional parts of the Trollmaster, and then you could gain control of those aspects via the Trollmaster as well. But then, it's going a little bit further down the line, and I didn't want to make it too complicated for this one. It's already pretty complicated. So basically, all the environmentals are now taken care of. You've got your fresh air in, all the air out. You've got a dehumidifier controlling your humidity, and your lighting and your watering at this point is now fully controlled. Mm. Now it kind of comes down to how do you keep the plants alive. Obviously, with a hydroponic system, you're dealing with different nutrients. So now you've got salt-based nutrients. In this case, we're suggesting the mega solution nutrients. And then on top of that, you are also dosing your aminos. And then you've also got your silica as well. I prefer to use most of my silica during the veg period, and then kind of sort of cut it out throughout the flowering period. But those three together are going to be utilized in conjunction to keep the plants alive. And I do just want to say it's quite cost effective. I've now completed two full grows using nearly the exact same system mentioned here in front of us. And those two grows, I've just now got to the bottom of my 5 liter bottles. So it was, the system may seem quite pricey to set up, but then the running costs of the system are pretty decent.
So efficient, yeah.
Yeah. And just two more important facts of or components of hydroponics. Sometimes with the organics, we're allowed a bit lax on things like our pH and EC. But when you are dealing with a reservoir, and you've got different nutrient combinations and different requirements at different times, you need to really be on top of your pH, obviously testing where your pH is, but also looking at your EC. If you follow the suggested on the bottle, it's not always going to come in exactly right. So you need to have the control of the EC pane to be able to test where your EC is, and then either add more water to bring the EC down, or add more nutrients to bring the EC up, dependent on where you find yourself in, either in the veg or where in the flowering stage you are finding yourself.
100%. And then obviously all of your electrics are going to get, it's worth having a surge protector. It wasn't maybe an absolute necessity. Same with the power meter. If you want to monitor some of your costs in terms of consumption of electricity, that's really useful with regards to a power meter. The spray bottle is useful for your IPM management, which is, and any foliar sprays, which is also sort of a nice additional product. And then all the way in the top right here, we have the carbon filter, which isn't a critical, but depending on your circumstances, it may be a critical. And I think that's pretty much, we've covered all of our things. I mean, we'd love to do a follow-up on this, on like how to actually grow hydroponically, which would then, I mean, now you guys know the ingredients, which is usually a difficult part for us for someone to explain, and then we can touch on like how to set up each of these, which would be quite a cool video. Dean, anything in closing that additionals?
Yeah, I think for someone who hasn't grown hydroponics before, they really think it's highly complicated, and I mean there's complications to both sides, but to be able to look here and to visualize each component and to see how each component works together, I think it actually really simplifies it. And once you can understand what each component is doing in the system, it really makes it seem far more achievable for those of you who have been scared to try it out thus far, Or maybe someone who's building a system and they're not 100% sure what goes where, you know. So everything works quite nicely together, and it's I must personally say it's quite fun to start playing around with slightly more irrigation, you know, irrigation aspects, and you know, building slightly larger systems, because you know, really, once you understand the basics of this, you can go so far with it.
Yeah, I mean, everything in the system is interchangeable. I mean, you could choose a different light. There's different, instead of Trollmaster, you could use the Smart Life systems. Instead of the 150 inlines, you could do a 200. You can do two times 100s, different piping, different pump selection, different humidifiers. There's pH pens across the board. So it's like very, you know, it makes it difficult because it's such a fluid system and there's so many different nutrients that you could use, so many different things. But this is the standard formula. So it's not a specific base on like you have to have these products, but you have to have a sort of nutrient set. You have to have sort of a piping system. You have to have a environment and environment control. So if you guys understand this as a concept, you can basically, the world's your oyster. Anyway, that's all from us today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please make sure to like and subscribe. It's the only way to support the channel. Share it with any friends. And until next week. Peace, guys.
Peace, guys.